Good afternoon to everyone. This is Simp Master. In the last class, we have discussed about a normal distribution. Today, I'll continue here a uniform distribution that is also a type of continuous random variable. So the definition of uniform distribution, here it is given as agar uniform distribution means everywhere the distribution is the same, it should be constant. Like if X is a uniform random variable is there, that is a follows a uniform distribution, and the interval is given alpha comma beta, then its probability density function is f of X is given as 1 by beta minus alpha, and where X is varies from alpha to beta. So in that case, to find out the mean, it is a alpha plus beta divided by 2. The mean is nothing but its expectation. If you integrate from alpha to beta and x into f of x dx, you will get the mean is this is there. Correct. So here, expectation is it's alpha plus beta divided by 2. And to find out the variance, we'll apply here E of x square minus expectation of x for whole square. If you apply it here, you'll get the variance is beta minus alpha whole square divided by 2. To find out the expectation of x square, you need to integrate from alpha to beta. It's a x square into f of x dx. And here we have already found that mean, and the mean is here alpha plus beta divided by 2 per whole square. This could simplify for everyone. And you will get the variance is beta minus alpha whole square divided by 12. So you can substitute the function value is how much? It's a x into 1 minus beta minus alpha. And this one, if you integrate it here with respect to x, you will get it here x square by 2. And you put it the limit from alpha to beta. The 1 minus beta minus alpha is constant, and you take out the 2 is outside. So this will be beta square minus alpha square. And beta square minus alpha square is, I can split them as a beta minus alpha into beta plus alpha. And 1 beta minus alpha and 1 beta minus alpha, it will get cancelled. You will get it in the last, it's a beta plus alpha divided by 2. So ye mean hum log find out kar sakte. Yani whatever the interval is given, you just substitute the interval and divide it by 2. Correct. So, yahan pe agar like if the interval is given minus a to plus a, this is the interval is given. Yani the x is varies from minus a to plus a. It means yahan pe hum log function ka value ko find out kar sakte hain. It's a plus a, and it will be equal to 2a. Because alpha is here minus a and the beta is here plus a. If you substitute that here at this equation, you'll get f of x in this part. Similarly, to find out the mean, and the mean will be how much? It will be 0. Because a minus a, it's a 0. But to find out the variance, you need to take it here beta minus alpha. So that will be a square by 12. It's a beta plus beta minus alpha means it will become 2a square. So 2a square means it will be a square by 3 if you simplify that. So it depends upon the interval, what the interval is given. With the help of interval, you can find out the function value. And after that, you can find out the expectation of that one and the variance. Correct. So look, we'll check it here. Next question, there's one question is there based on that uniform distribution. A point is randomly selected with uniform probability in xy plane within rectangle bounded by x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, and y is equal to 0, and y is equal to 2. So if you make the diagram here, so this is the here x, y is equal to 0 line, and this y axis is called x is equal to 0. So x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1. So somewhere the x is equal to 1 is this one is the line. And y is equal to 2 means this is the line. So hamesha dhyan dena ki the slope of uniform distribution is always rectangle. The slope of uniform distribution, you will get it here always rectangle. So it is given that if L is the length of the position vector of the point, then the expected value of L square. And he's asking to find out the mean. Expected means expectation. So there is a one point is that, and then let's say that this point is xy, and you need to find out here position vector. Let L is the length of this position vector. So I need to find out that this length, L. So now to find out that this length, we'll try to find out first of all function value. So what is the function of this line from here to here? And what is the function of this line from here to here? So there's the interval is given. First interval is given 0, 1. They apply the function value. So f of x, you know that it's a beta minus alpha. So this will be beta and this will be alpha. If you substitute that, 1 - 0 = 1. So f of x, I got it here, 1. Same way to find out next interval is given 0, 2. That is going along a y direction, because this is the 0, 0 and this is 0, 2. So to find out the function value, so this time it will be f of y, and f of y it will be 2 - 0. It's a 1/2. See, I can say that the value, this L will be equal to what? To the coefficient. This is x and this is y. So, yahan se L square is equal to, I can say that x square plus y square. If you apply the Pythagoras theorem, now you take the expectation on both the sides. If you take the expectation of x square plus y square, this ko hum log split kar sakte. E of x square into E of y square. And E of x square kaise find out karenge? You need to integrate from 0 to 1. Kyunki expectation for continuous random variable is given at 0 to 1. X square into f of x dx. And expectation for y square is 0 to 2. Iska function value y vary kar raha 0 to 2 tak. And here it is a y square into f of y into dy. So now you substitute that. This is a 0 to 1. X square and f of x kitna 1. So substitute that 0 to 2 and y square and f of y is how much? It's a 1/2 into dy. Integrate it here. So this will be x cube by 3 and integrate from 0 to 1. And this one y 1/2 take out. Right? So this is the y cube by 3 and integrate from 0 to 1. So if you integrate it here, you will get it 1/3. And if you integrate it here, that's a y cube. If you put the limit, it will be 8/3 into 2. So 2 fours are 8. It's a 1/3 + 4/3. The answer will be a 5/3. And the expected value of this point lying inside the this rectangle, and for the probability of getting a point inside the rectangle is a 5/3. That's the meaning. So, yahan pe hum logo kya karna? I need to find out the expectation of this L square. To uske liye mujhe function value find out karna hai. That is along x axis and that is along y axis also. Along y axis, we find out karna hai. So, this is the one problem is that with, based on uniform probability. So whenever you are solving the based on uniform probability, you need to find out the function. Similarly, there is one more distribution is there, that is exponential distribution. And AV distribution that comes under the continuous random variable. So the probability density function of the exponential distribution of is given as f of x is equal to lambda e raised to minus lambda x, where lambda is called here, it's a product of n into p, where n is a number of observation, and this p is called here probability of success. So is case mein to find out the mean, we have a formula. If you integrate it from 0 to infinity, kyunki yahan pe dekho, the function value is only valid for when x is greater than or equal to 0. Means it should vary from 0 to infinity. So here you write down x into f of x dx. This is the mean formula. So f of x value you substitute here. 0 to infinity, x you write down. And f of x is e lambda e raised to minus lambda into x dx. So you take out the here lambda value common, lambda, and e raised to minus lambda x. So the remaining is 0 to infinity. It's a x into e raised to minus lambda x into dx. Isko integrate. If you integrate it here, this one, you will get definitely 1 by lambda square. Definitely you will get it 1 by lambda square. So it's a 1 by lambda, you will get it here. Similarly, to find out the variance, apply the same formula. Variance click your formula. So it's a 0 to infinity x square into f of x dx minus 0 to infinity x into f of x dx. A formula. Jahan jahan f of x hai, you substitute the value lambda into e raised to minus lambda x. So you'll get it here 1 by lambda square is a exponential distribution. So remember that whenever the function value is related with exponential, that is exponential distribution. So hamesha jo question pooch jate hai, that is a mean and variance. And sometimes they'll give you the function value and they'll ask you to find out the probability. Jaise ki is question mein dekhte hain, yahan pe dekho, the f of x is given 1 by 5 e raised to minus x by 5. Yani by seeing the questions only, we'll understand that it's the exponential distribution. And I need to find out the probability when x is greater than 5. So x is greater than 5 means x should vary from 5 to infinity. Because exponential distribution means it varies from minus infinity to plus infinity, but bola hai yeah, 5 se jyada hona chahiye. The x ka jo variation hoga 5 to infinity. Yani I'll integrate it this one 5 to infinity of f of x dx. So 0 to it's a 5 to infinity, and f of x value is given 1 by 5. It's a 1 by 5 e raised to minus x by 5. Dx. So yahan pe 1 by 5 you take outside common. So e raised to minus x by 5 ko integrate karenge. So you'll get it here. You have to divide by minus 1 by 5 and 5 to infinity. See 1 by 5, 1 by 5 get cancelled. So minus you put it here. Now put the limit. So upper limit if you put it here in place of x, it will become e raised to minus infinity minus upper limit minus lower limit. So lower limit is 5. So 5 divided by 5 means it's a 1. So you have minus 0 e raised to minus 1. So further, if you simplify it, you will get it here e raised to minus 1. That is 1 by e is right answer. So the option number B is right answer. Kuch nahi karna hai yahan pe. Bahut simple hai. You need to just integrate it here. Similarly, there is one more question in there that is based on exponential distribution. यहाँ पे दिया गया है कि f of x alpha into e raised to minus alpha t dt, where t is greater than and equal to 0. Means we need to integrate 0 to infinity. But यहाँ पे बोल दिया गया है, find the probability that p, that is t is varies from 100 to 200. And it's greater than 100 but less than 200. See, if you integrate it here, so you need to give the limit from 100 to 200. This ka integration hoga, that is the p of this one is given as integration f of x dx. But yahan pe variation kya alpha, so we need to integrate. Okay, not it's a t is the variable in there, so we need to integrate this one with respect to dt. So alpha you take out outside common, alpha you take out outside common. And e raised to minus alpha t integration is minus alpha t divided by minus alpha and integrate it from 100 to 200. E alpha and alpha get cancelled, minus is remaining here. E raised to minus alpha t 100 to 200. Now put the limit. So this will be substitute the limit in place of t. It will become here minus 200 alpha ho jayega, and this will be minus 100 alpha. Or if you multiply them, so you will get it here e raised to minus 100 alpha minus e raised to minus 200 alpha. So I can say that the option number A is right answer, but the alpha is not there in the option. Alpha must be. So it's a none of the options are matching, but if you put it here alpha, then the option number is right answer. There is some question mistakes are there here. It should be alpha. So this is a problem based on the exponential distribution. देखो next है जो हम लोग के पास है regression coefficient और regression length. तो देखो यहाँ से भी एक दो question पूछे जाते हैं. तो यहाँ से हमेशा जो हम लोग को question पूछे जाते हैं that is a R. R means it's a coefficient of correlation. It's a coefficient of correlation. तो उसके लिए formula है कैसे हम लोग find out करते हैं. जैसे कि दिया हुआ R is equal to एक formula दिया हुआ था that is a S X Y divided by root under S S X into S Y Y. ये S को हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं. It's a regression coefficient. Regression coefficient. I'm not going to drive it, but you remember the formula where S X Y is given as summation X I minus X bar into Y Y minus Y bar. यहाँ पे X bar क्या होता है. It's a mean. The mean is you can find out summation of x divided by number of observation and y bar you can find out sum of y divided by number of observation. Similarly xx you can find out xi minus x bar whole square or yy you can find out y bar yi minus y bar whole square. So, yahan se hum log r find out kar sakte hain that's coefficient of correlation. This pe based hum log ke paas question hai jaise ki ye question dekho. This is the question we need to find out here. Find the coefficient of correlation that we need to find out here. R. Okay, so R formula we know that it's a S X Y divided by root under S X X into root under S Y Y. देखो here you need to make the table X का table बनाओ and Y का table. Minus 1, 0, 3, 2 is given and 1, 2. 3, 2 is given. So, यहां से देखो हम लोग फाइंड आउट कर सकते हैं x बार. x बार क्या होगा? It's a sum of x divided by number of observation. इसका सम करेंगे तो 3 plus 2, 5 minus 1, 4 and 4 divided by 4 means 1. तो x बार यहां पे 1 आ गया. Similarly, to find out y bar, I'll do that sum of y divided by number of observation. तो सम कितने हैं इसका? इसका सम है इट्स अ 3 प्लस 2 5 प्लस 3 8 8 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 मींस इट्स अ 4. सो आई गॉट इट हियर द y बार आई गॉट इट हियर इट्स अ 4. द y बार आई गॉट इट हियर इट्स अ 4. सो नेक्स्ट व्हाट आई नीड हियर I need here X, capital X. So where the capital X, ये जो capital X होता है, it's a X minus X bar. And a capital Y जो होते हैं, it's a Y minus Y bar. That is here capital X and capital Y. Remember that. It's a capital X. So that one is given as X minus X bar. So चलो, X minus X bar means this is the X bar is there and this is the X is there. So minus 1, minus 1, it's a minus 2. 0 minus 1, it's a minus 1. 3 minus 1, it's a 2. And 2 minus 1, it's a 1. Now you just add them. Add them. So, okay, this is the X. And similarly, to find out Y, it's a Y minus Y bar. The Y is a 4. The 4 minus 1 is 3. No. It's a Y minus Y bar. So 1 minus 4 is minus 3. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. 3 minus 4 is minus 1. And 2 minus 4, it's a 2 minus 4, it's a 2. Okay, look at here. While finding the y bar value, you need to divide by 4 because the number of observation is here, 4 is there. So 8 by 4, it is given as 2. So here you got the y bar value is it's a 2, not 4. So here there's a mistake is there in finding y. Now you do that 1 minus 2, it's a minus 1. 2 minus 2, it's a 0. And 3 minus 2, it's a 1. And 2 minus 2, it's a 0. Now after that, you find out here xy. एक्स वाई कितने होंगे, तो यू मल्टीप्लाई टू माइनस टू माइनस टू माइनस वन इट्स टू, माइनस टू इंटू जीरो इट्स जीरो, एंड टू इंटू वन इट्स टू, एंड वन इंटू जीरो इज जीरो. यू टेक द एडिशन ऑफ दिस ऑल, यू विल गेट इट हियर फोर. Similarly, next I need here SXX. So SXX is nothing but it's a x square. So you just take the square of this one. So minus 2 ka square is 4, and minus 1 ka square is 1, and 2 square is 4, and here 1 square is 1. Now you just add them, so you'll get it here SXX. So it's a 10. And similarly, to find out here y square, so you take the square of this y value. So minus 1 ka square, it's 1, 0 ka square, 0. Then again, 1 square is 1, and 0 square is 0. So if you take the sum of this one, you'll get it here. Now use the formula. So SXY, how much we got it here? 4. And SXS, we got it at 10. And it's a root 2. If you simplify them, you will get the answer 0.89. So always remember that the coefficient of relation must be here less than 1. So if you simplify them, so you will get it to 0.89. So what are the things you need to do that? You need to find out capital X first of all. Capital Y, the capital X is X minus X bar. The first step is to find out the X bar. And X bar is the sum of X divided by number of observations. That's a 4 by 4 is 1. The one I got it here, X bar. Y bar same way, sum of Y divided by number of observations, you will get it here too. After that, you go for the similar procedure and find out and use this formula. Based on that, ek aur hamare paas problem hai, jaise ki it's given that if y is equal to x plus 1 and x is equal to given that 3y minus 7 are the two regression line, then the coefficient of correlation is, it's r1. To uske liye bhi hamare paas method hai, dekho, regression line of y on x. Dekho, kaise hum log find out karte hain, agar koi bhi equation diya hua hai, like the equation is given 3y is equal to 5x plus 3 is given. So, मुझे अगर इसको हमको standard form में लिखना है. Standard form means you need to write down y minus y bar is equal to x minus x bar. This is the standard form there. And whatever the coefficient, that one is represented at r into sigma y by sigma x. तो यहाँ पे y को resolve करो and I can write down 5 by 3 x plus 3 by 3. So, ये जो represent करता है, it's a byx. And byx is here, this is nothing but it's a byx. So byx ka naam kya hai? It's a regression line of y on x. Ye important hai. Regression line of y on x. So it is given as y minus y bar is equal to r into sigma y by sigma x. So agar y ke liye find out kar rahe hai, to sigma y must be up. So the byx is given as this one, r into sigma y by sigma x. Same with the regression line of x on y. So x on y means yahan se hum log x find out karenge. So x will be given as 3 by 5 into y minus 3. Yeah, ye ho jayega aapki bxy and it's a 3 by 5. So that is also given as r into sigma x by sigma y. But sigma yahan pe kya hai? That's a standard deviation. Standard deviation. Sigma y and sigma y. X. So x minus x bar is equal to bxy into y minus y bar, where bxy is r into sigma x by sigma y. So to find out the coefficient of correlation, you just multiply. Ye dono ko just multiply kar. So byx into bxy is equal to r into sigma y by sigma x by sigma y. So ye sigma, it will get cancelled. You will get it r into r is r square. So r square is equal to, you will get it here bxy into byx. So r will be equal to root under bxy into byx. So yahan pe to find out the coefficient of correlation, I need bxy and byx. So bxy kya hai? It's a coefficient of y. It's a coefficient of y. And byx kya hai? It's a coefficient of x. So based on that only, you check it here, this question. Just like diya hua y is equal to diya hua x plus 1. And x is equal to 3y minus 1, 3y minus 7 diya hua. Isko hum convert karenge, x is equal to, agar y is equal to x plus 1, to hum likhenge isko y is x is equal to x minus 1. Yani isko hum transform ki x minus x bar is equal to r into sigma x by sigma y into y minus y bar. And इस पूरा टर्म को हम लोग बोलते हैं इट्स अ बी एक्स वाई. यहाँ पे बी एक्स वाई हम लोग बोल सकते हैं इट्स अ वन, द कोएफिशिएंट इज वन. बी एक्स वाई जो भी वाई का कोएफिशिएंट होगा इसको इक्वेट कर दो ये होगा बी एक्स वाई. सिमिलरली इसको कन्वर्ट करो वाई माइनस वाई बार इज इक्वल टू आर इंटू सिग्मा वाई बाई सिग्मा एक्स इंटू एक्स माइनस एक्स बार. सो वाई इज इक्वल टू हम इसको लिख सकते हैं इट्स एक्स बाई थ्री प्लस सेवन. सो यहाँ पे जो भी कोएफिशिएंट होगा x का दैट इज गिवन एज बी वाई एक्स. बी वाई एक्स एंड बी वाई एक्स इज हाउ मच इट्स अ 1 बाय 3 एंड दैट इज आल्सो गिवन एज r इनटू सिग्मा y बाय सिग्मा x. तो अगर दोनों को मल्टीप्लाई करके तो टू फाइंड आउट द r वैल्यू इट्स अ बी एक्स वाई इनटू बी वाई एक्स इट्स अ 1 इनटू 1 बाय रूट 3 वैल्यू. So you'll get it here 1 by root 3 and 1 by root 3 is it's a 0.45 is given as. Not it's a 0.45, I think it's a 0.57 is the right answer. Yes, 0.57. So bahut easy hai, is type ka agar regression line diye hue hain, so you need to just find out the byx and dxy. Byx means what? It's a regression of y on x. Regression of y on x. And bxy means what? It's a regression of x on y. So you need to convert the standard equation or standard line equation as a x is dependent variable and y is independent variable. And y on x means y is a dependent variable and x is independent. Bahut easy question hai. Jaise ki agar hum bolte hain yahan pe, like if it is given here, it's given 3x plus 5y is equal to 7 is given and 5x plus 9y is equal to 3 is given. To yahan se humko ye dono se humko r find out karna hai. R. So from here, ek ko regression you do that regression of y on x. Y on x means I'll write down 5y is equal to minus 3x plus 7. So y is equal to minus 3 by 5 into x plus 7. So ye ho jayega, that is a byx and byx is minus 3 by 5. Similarly yahan se ab find out karo x on y. X on y means 5x is equal to minus 9y plus 3. X is equal to minus 9 by 5 plus 3. So this will be at the BXY. That's a 9 by 5. Now to find out the R value, you just take the square root of minus 3 by 5 and minus 9 by 5. So it will be here 27 by 25. So you'll get it here root under 27 by 5. Root under 27 by 5 here. You simplify then you'll get the negative. देखो यहाँ पे अगर दोनों regression coefficient अगर negative है, तो you'll get the r value जो negative. जैसे कि r is equal to it's a plus minus root under bxy and byx दिया जा रहा है. क्योंकि r की r square किधर लाएंगे? That is a square root. If यहाँ पे ध्यान देना कि अगर byx and bxy अगर positive है, तो r value will be positive. और byx and bxy अगर negative है, then r value will be negative here. So these are the problems are there. You can do that here. This type of problem very easily. So these are the problems that is related to and the topics are related to based on probability. So this is the end of the probability is there. So thank you everyone. I'll keep it this much only for today's.